Chicago, Nico Horner. Horner, a guy you think about with a strong baseball IQ, but just the overall smarts. He comes from an educational background. Both of his parents at one time taught at Stanford, and his mom currently is on the faculty at Cal. Kicks and deals. Makes the grab, one away. Dansby Swanson stands in. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. 1-1 now. Left field. De La Cruz drifts towards it. Two down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Here's a 1-1. Foul ball.
All sliders so far in this at bat to get ahead in the count, and clearly shows there was a game plan in mind for how to attack him in the box.
Ground ball right side. Birdie fires over to first, and that is that. Cubs are down quietly, and now the Marlins will have a crack at things. No score. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Welcome back. Our starter in this one, Justin Steele.
Well, he's been a very dependable starter for his club, and what stands out for me is that left-handed hitters have really struggled batting below 200 against him, and it just tells me they have a hard time tracking the baseball. Maybe it's the release point, maybe it's the motion, but just some way, somehow, they've got to figure out a way to pick it up and try to have some success from the left side.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And at the plate for Miami, John Birdie, the lefty ready, and a 1-1. Bunting for a hit, and foul ball. And a ball and two strikes. Swing and a ball popped up. Swanson under it. Makes the catch, and there's one gone.
Batting second, the designated hitter, Garrett Cooper.
And now it's Garrett Cooper up to him. Good contact guy, good defender. And that's ball four.
Perfect.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted in first base with a quick free pass.
Luis Arraez stands in. The pitch. Line drive, and it's caught for the out.
Batting four. The right fielder, Jorge Soler.
Jorge Soler up at the plate. Cooper, the runner at first with two gone. Next pitch misses, 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
And there's a ball. And now it's filled up. To third, Rios. That's out number three. Marlins leave one. We played an inning, no score. And welcome back. New inning getting started. Now it's the right fielder, Seiya Suzuki. Obviously a guy who makes good contact, hits for average, but one of the things in today's game, the value in the fact that he hits both righties and lefties. Liner to second and picked on the hop. Birdie fires over to first. One up, one down.
Batting fifth, the center fielder, number 24.
One down, here comes Cody Bellinger. Singy, he's a guy that covers both sides of the plate about as well as anyone in the sport. How difficult is that to do?
Well, just look at the back of my bubblegum card. You'll see how hard it is. These guys are great, man. They have the ability to look out there, but also to be able to turn on the inside pitch. Those that can really sharpen things on the outer half, those are the ones that become elite.
There's a swing and a drive. Holds it in on the warning track.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it, but sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. You're looking for one of those bloop hits to get a knock sometimes.
So digging in, Patrick Wisdom. Good power, not great in the OBP department. And it's even up.
Two strikes.
Nowadays, with advanced metrics and increased use of moving the infielders around, defense isn't necessarily about making errors. Are you able to get to the ball? Are you able to position fielders where guys hit the ball, but within the new shift rules? And it's through for a hit. So a two-out knock keeps the inning alive.
Seven.
Hooked around that pitch on the outside, but he was still able to square it up pretty nicely, and that takes quick, strong wrist to pull that off.
Man at first, Eric Hosmer, the next Cub to hit. Next offering is in for a strike.
And an area that goes unnoticed is the coach that's responsible for positioning, and then the research person that's providing the information. So what we're seeing in baseball, so many more people behind the scenes that are contributing to the success between the lines.
On to first, out number three. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one left. We go to the bottom of inning number two. We're tied, nothing, nothing. Back here in Miami, bottom half of inning number two. Gene Segura at the plate here. Back when you played, it wasn't the empirical data we have now. It was a guy with a ruler and a diamond taking a colored pencil and drawing a line. Oh, nice stop on a slide. And that's a great play for the out.
Batting six, the center fielder.
Jazz Chisholm Jr. now. Falling behind 2-1. Steal. He has a reputation, I don't know, maybe a knack for working himself out of tough situations that he finds himself in. You know, you like that in a relief pitcher, but when you have it for a starting pitcher, a guy that can get out of a tight spot, that is pretty valuable. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. Two up, two down.
Oh, nothing too fancy on the strikeout pitch right there. Just a low 90s fastball, and I'm not sure he was trying to challenge him, but that's pretty much what happened. Very hittable location, but he found a way to just get it by him.
Now at the plate, Nick Fortes.
And you won't see the skipper rush to get somebody up in the bullpen as soon as he starts to see some signs of trouble. This guy's earned a longer leash, and because of that, confidence grows with the players and teammates playing behind him that when things get a little rough out there, they know he'll find his way through it.
Bellinger makes the grab, and that's the inning. And 1-2-3 go the Marlins. We'll move to the third with no score. Back here at the ballpark, now the third baseman, Edwin Rios.
He's got pop, which is a little sneaky because he's so comfortable with taking his base hits to the opposite field, but he can jump you if you make a mistake.
That one in for a strike, 2-2. The pitch. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Now it's Yan Gomes. Yan Gomes waits. Now a pop up on the infield. And puts the squeeze on it. That's out number two.
The batter number two. Second baseman.
Here's Nico Horner. He's 0 for 1. Feels like it's less common today that you see a guy like this. The speed component, the contact component, but lack of power. Next offering is downstairs.
He just has to understand that his skill set is unique and he's very valuable for any ball club. If he does that, he'll play a long time in this league.
That catches the top part of the zone. Three balls, two strikes. Swing and a ball popped up and it drops in, and that extends the inning. Dansby Swanson is going to get a chance to hit. 0 for 1 with a flyout. The pitch. And there's ball four.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
Ian Happ up to hit. Grounded out his first time.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Lined into left center, should be extra bases. Runner around third on his way to the plate. One runs in. Another comes in to score. It's 2-0. It's a two-run double, and they have the lead. So two down. So now it's the Cubs hitter in the four hole, Seiya Suzuki. Grounded out his first time up. Runner leads away at second.
Ball two.
Two outs. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again.
And the strategy of winning a ball game, when you can make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job.
Now this one gets through. Now a long throw home. The run comes in to score from second. It's 3-0.
Well done. Drives in the run. Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit.
Runner at first with two away. Here's the center fielder, Cody Bellinger. 0 for 1 so far. The count 2-1. Swing and a miss. And a 2-2. And a swing and a miss. Good job at damage control right there. Three runs for them here, and they move ahead. We move on to the bottom of inning number three. It's the Cubs 3 and the Marlins nothing. Welcome back as we go to the last of the third. And now, Brian De La Cruz.
De La Cruz.
At the belt and fires. That's to third. Rios throws on to first. One up, one down.
Batting ninth. The shortstop.
Garrett. Here's Garrett Hampson. This is a guy you got to keep an eye on when he digs in. Definitely been known to drop a drag bunt from time to time, and he's pretty good at it, Chris.
Yeah, and he creates a sense of urgency for the defense because of the speed, because of the ability to put down that bunt.
Stays alive. Now you see even sluggers from time to time try and use the bunt really as a way to beat the shift. Base knock right field.
Gotta love the resiliency he showed in that at bat, battling with two strikes. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you gotta make them pay. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Back to the top of the lineup, John Birdie at the plate. Payoff pitch. Goes down swinging for the strikeout. He swung over top of the curveball. And Chris, that's a way to neutralize his speed by keeping him off base.
And the defense breathes a sigh of relief because he puts pressure on everyone if he can put the ball in play. But that's how you do it. Keep him off balance, get him out of there, and deal with the next guy.
Now snap throw to first. Hampson back on a dive. Hampson off of first with two away. That's in there. And the count is even, 2-2.
Well, if he's going to steal second, you want him to go early in the count. That way he's not a distraction to the hitter at the plate. Go ahead and get it out of the way so the hitter can focus on the pitch.
And that one is lifted in the air. Bellinger drifts towards it. Puts the squeeze on that one. And that'll end the inning. One left for Miami. They trail in this one 3-0. Back here at Lone Depot Park as we go to the top of the fourth. Here's some real power at the plate. Patrick Wisdom. Chris, dig this. Patrick Ian Cashel Wisdom. His middle name is Ian Cashel. Ian, Gaelic slash Scottish for John, named after his grandfather John at his dad's side. And then Cashel is a little village in Ireland where his mom's family is from. Goes down looking.
Well, it's just a great job of playing catch with the catcher. Exactly where the catcher set up is where he threw that pitch. And probably fooled the umpire a little bit because there was no budge at all.
Now it's Eric Hosmer. 0-for-1, he grounded out in his first at bat. Next offering is in for a strike. He got to visit in 2019, saw the house where they all grew up, about 45 minutes west of Galway, near Roundstone on Cashel Bay, and his daughter Claire has the same middle name, Cashel. This one lifted in the air, left field, and that's a fair ball. Around first and hustling for second, and that's a two-bagger. Edwin Rios here. He was a strikeout victim his first time. That misses the zone, and that's ball three.
Three balls, one strike.
Runner at second here, one gone. Three-one, and he couldn't come up with it.
Now bad.
Here's Yan Gomes. First time up was a pop out. Ball to strike. The pitch. Late that time, and it's strike two. Miami's bullpen with some action. Dylan Floro is loosening up. This would be his first appearance for the club. Got it by him for the K.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Guys become defensive, and all of a sudden, for the hitter, that plate starts to get really wide. And what happens is, because of the pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout.
And now, Nico Horner. 2-1 pitch is in there, and the count is even.
If he can get through this one, put up a zero, this will help in his outings to come.
Two outs, a couple of base runners at first and second. Birdie fires over to first, and that'll do it. Cubs strand a couple, but they lead it 3-0. And welcome back. John Ciambi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Luis Arraez. To the right side, corner. Leadoff hitter retired in the fourth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Now here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Jorge Soler. Grounded out his first time. One down, base is empty. That one missed. Now fouls it back with two strikes. And a pitch. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. 2-2 now. The other way, and he beats the shift.
Now batting, third baseman.
Dominant performance for him today, Boone. Just two hits allowed so far. No runs across either. And he's had an answer for just about every hitter he's faced. So I don't think this hit is going to knock him off his stride too much.
Here's the third baseman, Gene Segura. He's 0 for 1. That pitch gets the inside corner. And the count 1 and 2. Soler stands at first with one out. Now a screamer into the outfield. Suzuki snags it for the second out.
Now the center fielder, Jazz Chisholm Jr.
And up next for Miami, Jazz Chisholm Jr. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. You know, it's no surprise that Jazz Chisholm Jr. is good at baseball. His grandmother, Patricia Coakley, actually played shortstop for the Bahamian National Softball Team. And get this, she didn't retire until her 60th birthday. She started to play soft toss with Jazz when he was only 2 years old. Next pitch is outside. Gets a piece and stays alive. Comes a 2-2. Good eye right there.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Blows the high heat past him. That's a strikeout. Marlins leave one. They trail it here 3-0. Pitcher on here, Dylan Floro.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep him within striking distance.
Number 58, Dylan Floro.
Now it's the shortstop, Dansby Swanson.
Swanson, former first-round pick by the Arizona Diamondbacks. Vanderbilt player in college, College World Series player, all that good stuff, but really coming into his own.
Fastball in for a strike, 1-2. Fights it off, he'll see another. Swing and a ball popped up, and out number one on the grab.
The left fielder, number 8, Ian.
To the batter now, Ian Happ, 1-2. And he deals. And a count 1-2. And here it comes. hat. Tries to check his swing. Now a look to third. And he couldn't hold back. He's rung up on strikes.
Now batting. Right fielder.
Seiya Suzuki now at the plate. Suzuki. Out to short. Over to first. That's the third out. And the Cubs are down in order. But they're on top by a count of 3-0. Back here in Miami, bottom of the inning. Here's the catcher, Nick Fortes. This guy, one of the best defensive catchers going. You talk about framing. The ability to block, catch, and throw. He is at the top of the game. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Typically, that high fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, a hitter, if he's prepared for it, can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as that hitter's internal clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss.
Here's a 1-2. Just off the outside part of the plate.
Really good athlete. And many times we talk about, you know, the feet of infielders. This catcher as well, really quick feet. He's able to recognize the pitch, see the trajectory, and get into a spot where he can block those balls and keep them from going to the backstop.
And now the lefty chases the fastball up the ladder, struck him out. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now 3 in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound.
Top of the sixth inning. So up now for Chicago, Cody Bellinger.
He's hitting for that pop. Came out of the gates really strong.
And the right-hander deals. And another ball. The 3-1 in for a strike, full count. The wind and the pitch. Swing, and this one's bounced on the ground. Fires over to first. Leadoff man retired in the sixth.
Patrick Wisdom.
Patrick Wisdom digs in now.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely, try to hit the ball out of the park, do what he loves to do.
Next offering is in for a strike. Slider misses outside. Here comes a pitch. And down on strikes he goes. Two down.
Well, big power guy right there and generating so much bat speed. It's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. He tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
Next pitch is outside. One thing throughout his career, Chris, people looking for him to hit the ball in the air a little bit more, hit for a tiny bit more power.
Yeah, just doesn't seem to get that lift and backspin consistently. Seen him have power, though, to the opposite field gap, which has been impressive.
The wind of the pitch. And that one missing low. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. And the inning is over. Nothing doing here this half. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Cubs 3 and the Marlins nothing. Back here at the ballpark, here's the second baseman, John Birdie. Chris, his skill set straight out of the mid-80s. Good contact, not much power, and he could run. He always uses the wheels to his advantage.
His biggest challenge in this day and age is to not get caught up in trying to hit home runs because so many people are.
Two balls and a strike. Here it comes.
I think baseball's starting to understand that those guys are valuable like they once were. They need him in this game today.
Caught him looking for the K.
Well, right now he's in cruise control, autopilot, just dominating these hitters. It doesn't look like it's a fun at bat. And all of a sudden, you become in awe of this guy on the mound. Somebody's got to break this thing up. That's five straight strikeouts. Got to put a ball in play.
And now the DH, Garrett Cooper. The pitch.
Ball.
And the pitch. Just missed.
Here's an opportunity to do some damage and perhaps unlock this offense. 3-1 count. Be ready to turn on a fastball.
Swing and a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Everything came together for him. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
And now, Luis Arraez. And a pitch. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2. Left-hand hitter waits. Line drive, base hit. They fired in quickly, so it's first and second with only one away.
Nice line drive to the pull side, met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and then ripped it into the outfield. Now let's see if they can string something together, make it a little more interesting.
Here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Jorge Soler. Kicks and fires. That one catches the zone. That is strike two.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
And a pitch. Check swing, appeal to first. No, he held up. Next offering is down low.
That's a really good take.
Gene Segura next to hit for the Marlins. One out. Runners at first and second. Swings and misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout.
So far, just one of those days for this lineup. You get a couple of runners on, and you're looking at having a big inning. And that strikeout right there just puts water on the fire. Look for the next hitter to step up and try to do something, pick up his teammate and his club.
Gene Segura, the next up for the Marlins. Swing and a miss. It's a ball and two strikes.
Man, I'm pretty impressed out there on the mound right now. I mean, these are tough spots where pitchers really got to bear down. Those last two pitches were well executed.
The next offering misses, and it's 2-2. Got him. And that is the inning. A couple of hits in the inning, but they can't get him home. Seventh inning coming up. It's the Cubs 3 and the Marlins nothing. So the Marlins go with a new arm, A.J. Puck. He last pitched 2 days ago. Yeah. Now the third baseman, Edwin Rios.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is, I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
Fouls it off, still 1-2. The pitch. And that one hit 97 on the gun.
Oh, really expanded the zone right there with that fastball off the outside corner of the plate. Got him to chase it. That's a tough one to lay off of because it starts close to you and just continues to run away from you in that batter's box. So it's a really nice pitch with two strikes.
The 1-1. And there's a ball. Signs of activity in the pen for the Marlins. Steven Oker appears to be getting loose. And a 2-1 on the way. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. So the batting order turns over. Now it's the second baseman, Nico Horner, 1-for-3. At the belt and fires. Check swing, tried to hold up, now an appeal to first. Yes, he did. That's a swing. Next to hit, Dansby Swanson. Gomes, off of first with two away. Now a fly ball to right center. Chisholm glides to his left. Drops into the glove. That is the inning. One left for the Cubs, but they lead it 3-0.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join us for the traditional 7-inning stretch.
We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Michael Rucker.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. Now pitching for the Cubs. Number 59, Michael Rucker.
Jazz Chisholm Jr. getting ready to hit. The Marlins in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
That one ripped left field, way back there. And gone! It's his sixth home run of the season, and they close the gap. It's 3-1.
Got in the jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden they're back in this ball game.
Nick Fortes, the next up for the Marlins, and a 1-2 and a foul ball. He stays alive.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up and you start to expect a big inning.
Righty delivers. That misses the zone. Two balls, two strikes. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Right-hander kicks, deals. That one 95 to finish him off.
The bat.
Ryan De La Cruz, the next up for the Marlins. The wind of the pitch. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there. It just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
Foul ball left side. He'll see another. K kicks and deals. And that's downstairs and outside. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. New pitcher in the game for the Cubs, Mark Leiter Jr. He's into the game with the bases empty.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for Chicago, number 38, Mark Leiter Jr.
And now for the Marlins, Garrett Hampson. Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Had him out front for strike three. Marlins get one back thanks to this solo homer. It's now a 3-1 ball game. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Back here at Lone Depot Park, ready to begin the eighth. Here's the left fielder, Ian Happ. The 1-1. And now the count, 1-2 after the swing and the miss. And he deals. Popped in the air, left field, and there's one down.
Up next is the right fielder,
Seiya Suzuki, the next Cub to hit. There's a 1-1. Late with the swing there.
Boom. That's cheddar, baby.
Here's a 1-2. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Sends it across to first. Two up, two down here in the top of the eighth.
The center fielder, number 24, Cody Bellinger.
Two outs, bases empty. And up to the plate comes Cody Bellinger. This is a true five-tool guy. Not very many of them out there, but when he's on the field, you can't take your eye off of him. The 1-1.
Fans come to the ballpark to watch him play. And in baseball, to have such a talented player going out there every day and putting on the show that he does, just a joy to watch.
That misses. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. The pitch. He goes down looking. Three up, three down for the Cubs. And the score stays 3-1. Welcome back. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. Now it's the Marlins leadoff hitter, John Birdie. Hits for average power, the ability to feel the arm, and then the speed. Really impressive. Next pitch inside, and that's ball two. Out to short, Swanson. The throw to first. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth.
The batter, the designated hitter, Garrett.
Garrett Cooper, the next up for the Marlins.
He was the big part of the field last time. Nice liner to center.
Ball and a strike. And a big swing and a miss.
Well, in this one, the offense has sputtered. Somebody's got to find a way to get on, keep the line moving, and manufacture at least one run. Then maybe you get two or three.
In the air, left side. Happ moving under it. And there's two down.
The first baseman, number three.
So two down now, and here is Luis Arraez. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. That's in there. 3-2 now.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. And the Marlins down quietly. Score holds. It's 3-1. Now on the bump, Stephen Okert. He pitched yesterday, and we'll see him once again.
Stephen Okert.
Now it's the DH, Patrick Wisdom.
The designated hitter.
He is very much your typical power hitter. I'd say he falls into the three true outcomes category.
Well, we've seen more and more of that lately. The ability to drive the ball to slog is getting heavily favored over any discipline or strikeout concerns. Boog, if I were him, I'd be nibbling around the plate as well. I mean, this guy is just capable of hitting pitches outside of the zone and driving them a long way.
So, man aboard. Eric Hosmer, the next Cub to hit. The 1-1. Popped up to the left, into foul ground. Segura snags it on the run.
Now batting, the third baseman, Edwin Rios.
Man at first, and up next for Chicago, Edwin Rios. Wisdom leads off first with one away. The pitch. And it goes just foul. One and two here. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. The pitch stays alive. Battling here as he fouls it away. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. He swings and hits a fly ball, center field. That one gets down for a hit. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out.
Well, I don't think that pitch would have been called a strike, but he did such a nice job of pulling his hands tight to the body and just getting enough of the barrel on it to be hard enough back up the middle for a knock.
And here's the catcher, Yan Gomes. Next offering is in for a strike. Two on, one out. That's down and in.
Definitely a swing and miss slider down and in. He finished that really well. Just couldn't get him to offer at it.
This one in the air, center field. Chisholm settles under it. He's got it. There's two away.
The batter number two, second baseman, Nico Horner.
So the lineup flips over. Here's the Cubs leadoff man, Nico Horner. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. And a pitch. Got him. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and two are left. On to the bottom of inning number 9. 4-5-6 coming up. It's the Cubs 3 and the Marlins 1. New pitcher now, Michael Fulmer. He comes in with a chance for his second save of the season.
Your attention, please.
Now here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Jorge Soler.
Look, this guy's definitely a plus runner, but what I love about him is that he goes all out every single time, never takes a break. It's guys like that, even though they don't have the elite speed, the fact that they're consistent with it they make moves on the base paths.
And the 3-1. And that one fouled off. Struck him out looking.
Well, the first batter, it's always a big one for the closer. I mean, you get that punch out, you get settled in, you feel like you're in command out there on the mound from the jump, and kind of prevents any doubt from creeping into your mind or the guys that are playing behind you that, you know, you're going to wrap this thing up.
In the air, right side. Suzuki has a beat on it. Two down.
Hey, man, four pitches, two outs. That is an excellent base.
The center field.
And at the plate for Miami, Jazz Chisholm Jr. He's already homered in this game. That misses. Two balls and a strike. And that one is inside.
Pressure mountain right here with the tying run and the on-deck circle. He's got to find the strike zone.
And a 3-1 on the way. And that one got a piece of him.
Now, biggest concern other than injury after a moment like that is just how the pitcher will respond. You know, sometimes a guy will lose confidence in a pitch when he's hit somebody.
Nick Fortes, the next up for the Marlins. Two-run game, a two away here in the bottom of the ninth. The tying run at the plate. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count.
Well, he hasn't gotten the result yet, but still pretty confident. Three foul balls in a row. He's right on this guy.
The 1-2. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Right-handed reliever. Fights that one away. Still 1-2. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Now he can't squeeze it behind the plate. No advance. Good job behind the dish.
Quite the matchup we're seeing here. Six foul balls in this at bat alone. Really making him work out there.
Got him! And that's the ball game.
3-1 ball game, quick game. We were looking for a little bit more. It seemed at points the offenses were going to break out, but a total of four runs combined. Really good pitching and defense on both sides. Just a couple of key swings making all the difference.
And your final 3-1. The Cubs go home a winner. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciampa.